Hey friends, my name is Yi, and today we have a new video for the IGCSE Geography playlist, and we have 1.2 Migration. And here's the specification from the website, and we have one case study, which is an international migration, which will look into the migration from Mexico to the USA. So here's some information on population migration. So here are some key terms. We have migration, which is basically describing the movement of people across a specified boundary. And then we have the push and pull factors. And basically, push factors are the negative conditions at the point of origin, or like the original country, that encourage people to move out of the country. And the opposite is pull factors, which are positive conditions at the point of destination, or the final destination country, that encourage people to move to that country. And we have the intervening obstacles. And here we have the least push and pull theory, which is basically building upon the push and pull factors. So least push and pull theory or model accounts for the push or pull factors and intervening obstacles in order to predict migratory patterns. So the push factors include poor job opportunities in the country, low income or wages, or like let's say natural disasters. And the pull factors of the point of destination include good opportunities, higher wages, or attractive environment. And as you can see, the push factors are often the opposite of pull factors, which basically prompts people to move from one country to the other. And there are types of migration that we'll look into. So we first look into the key terms. There's refugee and there's internally displaced people. And you can have a read at the definition. So here are the types of migration that we'll look into or that we'll focus on in this IGCSE geography specification. We have internal, which is basically the movement of people within a country. For example, from one state to another state within a country. And there's international, which is basically like a movement of people outside the country, like from one to another. There's voluntary, like people volunteer, they have a free choice. And there's involuntary, which is basically forced migration. There's temporary migration and there's permanent migration due to work or like say education. And then we have depopulation and counter-urbanisation. So here are some key terms. So depopulation is basically a decline in the number of people in a population. It's quite self-explanatory, like depopulation. And then we look into counter-urbanisation, which is the process of population decentralization as people move from large urban areas to smaller urban areas and rural areas. The opposite of this would be urbanization, where people move from rural areas to urban areas for better job opportunities. But there are many reasons why counter-urbanization happens, where people move from urban areas to, let's say, smaller urban areas. And this might be due to like cheaper housing prices or like cheaper things around the area, so they can build more land, bigger houses in that area. And there's decentralization, which is basically the movement of people or industry away from the center of a city to the suburbs or the edge of the town. And here's a quick note which I mentioned earlier. The objective of counter-urbanization is to seek a better quality of life by moving away from the province of larger cities. Yeah, and I mentioned it's basically the opposite of urbanization. And here we have some impacts of migration. So we have the impacts on the countries of origin. Like remittance, which is basically the money sent back by migrants to their families in their home community, are a major source of income in some countries. And this reduces pressure on the health and education system and housing in the country of origin, and as there's less people in their country of origin. But as people or young adult workers move away from a country, this causes brain drain. Because these young adult workers could have been working in that country, but they choose to move away. So there's brain drain in that country. And here are some impacts on countries of destination. Because more people are moving to the country of destination, there's an increased labor force. And the migrants bring important skills to the host nations because they might have skills that they could bring to the host nation. That's why they choose to move to that country. But the migrants are perceived to as taking jobs from the locals. And here are some impacts on the migrants. They have higher wages and better job opportunities, but they have high financial costs. and they do have the opportunity to explore new cultures and languages. And here's a case study, which is an international migration, and we'll look into Mexico to the USA. So here's some notes. In 2010, the world's biggest international migration route is from Mexico to the USA, as over 1 million Mexicans migrate to the USA every year. And here are some impacts of migration on the migrants, the positive and the negatives. Starting with the positive, because the USA is a developed country, they have better medical facilities. Therefore, the migrants will experience a better quality of life in the USA. And they have better job opportunities in the USA as there's more jobs in the US. However, the migrants may not have the required paperwork, so they face constant threat of deportation. And there might be a language barrier or cultural barrier between Mexico and the USA, as Mexico they speak Spanish and the USA they speak English. And one big thing is that the migrants can be exploited by employers. And there are some impacts on the host nations, or like the countries of origin and the countries of destination. So starting with the positive impacts of Mexico, like people like Mexicans send back money back to Mexico, and there's estimated around $24 billion in 2014 sent back to Mexico. And this reduces unemployment pressure in Mexico, and there's lower pressure on public services as there are less people. But as mentioned earlier, the negatives include brain drain, as the young adult workers move away that they could have been working in Mexico. And these migrants may return to Mexico with the changed values and attitudes they've obtained from the US. And the population might decrease and there might be more ghost towns in Mexico. And here are some impacts on the USA. The positive include many Mexicans are willing to work for low wages, for example in factories, which benefit US economy, and this makes goods cheaper to produce, which might lower the price across the US. But the negative might be more money spent on border patrols to keep illegal immigrants away from the US. And this is for this video for 1.2 migration for the IGCSE Geography playlist. And I hope you'll enjoy this video, and if you need any learning resources, you can check out my website in the description, or you can type it out in your browser at www.makesiteasy.com. And I hope you'll enjoy this video, and I'll see you all in the next video. Here's to learning made easy.